Yeah, hi, welcome everyone to this video. In this video, I'll explain you how we can use Azure pipelines to continuously deploy your containerized application to Azure Kubernetes service. So this is a kind of a walkthrough kind of video. This video, I will walk you through all the steps which will make it possible to deploy your application continuously from your source code from GitHub repository or maybe Azure repository directly to your AKS cluster. Now, in order to understand few things, means what are the components or what are the services that will be used, will be using in this particular demo or particular walkthrough. Number one, we need Azure DevOps subscription. You all need to have Azure DevOps subscription with you. Second thing that you need is Azure subscription to try AKS or to create AKS and to create ACR. We'll be creating two components here. Number one is Azure Container Registry, and the other one is Azure Kubernetes Service. That's all. I have both my subscriptions ready with me. What I'm planning to do is, I'm planning to deploy the necessary Azure Container Registry and Azure Kubernetes Service. Both I'm going to set up for this particular walkthrough now. And then I will explain you all the necessary steps into it. In this walkthrough, I'm just assuming that all of you know what is Azure Pipeline or Azure DevOps as a tool that help you to quickly build and deploy your application to multiple different targets. It could be on cloud, it could be on-premise, and so on. So here we start. I have already created a script. Let me check. Yeah, this is my script. I'm just going to fire the script and it will create both the resources on my Azure subscription. It will create a Kubernetes cluster with name MyAKS01, and it will create a container registry with name MyACR101. And while the script is creating necessary resources, I will explain you some of these components in brief. Okay, that way you will be ready to go with the demo. Here I'm creating the ACR, and then it will follow and create the Kubernetes cluster as well. This is going to take some nearly 5 to 10 minutes. Yeah, so here we go now. Continuous integration and continuous delivery or continuous deployment. This is how we are going to implement it. As far as continuous integration is concerned, Azure Pipelines allows you to build the CI pipeline or build pipeline that will take the source code from the given source code repository. We can call it check out the source step. Second step, we are going to then use Docker step or Docker extensions or Docker plugins in Azure DevOps to search for the Docker files. It could be Docker file or it could be a Docker Compose file. My current sample application has a Docker Compose file which describes all the services and components. So we'll use that file to actually run the Docker build, container build. So we are going to do these many things in here. Get the source code. After we got the source code, what we are going to do next is we are going to then build using the Docker Compose file that I have included in my application. My application Docker Compose file is configured in such a way that it will actually build the application images first and then use Docker Compose to, you know, build both the images and push them to the targeted container registry. After that, what we are going to do, my Docker Compose file or my Kubernetes pipelines, Kubernetes artifacts are already over there. I just have to make some small changes to those artifacts. What I have done is, in all my .yaml files that I'll be using for Kubernetes deployment, I have used some placeholders in the file. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to replace all the placeholders that I have created in Kubernetes deployment files. In my Kubernetes deployment files, at some places I have used some placeholders, and I need to replace those placeholders with the real values, like image name basically. What I'm going to actually replace here is image name or tag, whatever you call it. Let's call it image tag. What I'm going to do next after I did this, I'm going to copy these files into the drop container that we normally create at the end of Azure DevOps pipeline, build pipeline. What will it do? It will just copy all those modified deployment files, .yaml files, set of .yaml files into the build artifact folder, into a build artifact container, the drop container that we create at the end of build pipeline, so that it would be ready for our next pipeline, which is release pipeline. I'll be creating two pipelines in this particular application. First pipeline is going to be a build pipeline. Second pipeline is going to be a release pipeline. So my next pipeline is going to be a release pipeline. And what I'm going to do in this release pipeline? Number one, we will use the build artifacts. Now this time our build artifacts are nothing but simple Kubernetes deployment files or Kubernetes YAML files. We'll use them. And after that, what we are going to do, we're going to fire a simple Kubernetes steps or kubectl steps, kubectl step to apply these deployment files or Kubernetes deployment files directly to the target Kubernetes cluster. Obviously, in order to actually achieve that, some configuration need to be created first. Okay, some kind of configuration has to be created first. Okay, so this is what it is. In order to understand the overall structure, I will explain you with the help of a drawing what my application actually looks like. Here it is. So my application is basically a two-tier application. Number one is API, the REST API, which is developed using Java. It's a Java-based Spring Boot application. And number two is actually a database, a MySQL database. What I have done is I have split my application into a database and a REST API. This database over here already has the sample OrderDB database pre-initialized into it. And this is the application that will be connecting to this database. Now, what is my objective in here? My objective is to take these two-tier application, take this two-tier application and deploy it on Kubernetes cluster. And just for your reference, on my Kubernetes cluster, the same application will now appear like this. Okay? Within Kubernetes cluster, I'm going to create all the necessary component for it. I will have a config map. In Kubernetes, config maps are very important component. They allow you to externalize the configuration required by your containers. I'm going to use this config map to store the database credentials, username, password, database service name, and all those details. Other than that, I'm going to also define the deployment, the app deployment. Okay, this is basically the Kubernetes deployment object, which allows you to, you know, perform rolling update if required to release a new version of same application. We will have DB deployment that will actually help me to deploy a database. Right now for this demo, I'm using deployment object, but actually speaking, if you are deploying a database into a Kubernetes cluster, the recommended approach is to use stateful set. But in order to make this application a little less complicated, instead of using a stateful set, I'm using a normal deployment object in here. Fine. Other than that, I'm going to also define the services. So there is an app service, which is going to be a load balancer type service, which could be accessed from outside. This is going to be a public service. Once it is deployed, we'll get a public IP address to access it from outside the cluster. And then we will have DB service, which is not going to be accessible from outside. This is going to be an internal service. Okay, a private service. This is what all I'm going to deploy. This is what it will appear once it is deployed on my Kubernetes cluster. And this is what two containers I'm going to build. As far as my source code, or if you want to refer to the source code now, I have my entire source code hosted in my GitHub repository. You can visit my GitHub from this location. Spring REST to Docker Compose. This is the sample application we are going to deploy using Kubernetes. You will notice one thing, that this particular project here, if you look at the Docker Compose file, for example, it is already filled with image name and everything. This is not ready for the CI/CD pipeline as such. What I have done, I have created a new branch in here. We will be using this branch, AKS-CD, okay, for continuous deployment into Kubernetes cluster. And this is my application. This is my API, and this is my database. If you look at API, this is basically a Spring Boot, Maven Spring Boot application. And this database is actually just, you know, two files, a Docker file and order_db.sql, which contains the DML and DQL statement both necessary to set up my sample database. Let's have a look at my Docker Compose file. You will notice this file is using some placeholders in here. Okay, this placeholder, we are going to replace it with the actual image name at the time of build. I will show you how we can use this small extension called replace token extension from Azure DevOps that will allow me to replace these placeholders with their expected values. Okay, here it is all. Let's go back. These are my Kubernetes deployment artifacts, and you will notice one thing. Just like my Docker Compose file, my Kubernetes deployment artifact also contains the placeholders. So what I'm going to do is, at the CD pipeline, continuous deployment pipeline or continuous delivery pipeline, I'm going to replace these placeholders with their real values. Okay, I have used only two placeholders, by the way. One is for deployment of REST API, and the other one is for deployment of database. There are no other placeholders used anywhere else. All the other files are concrete files. No any kind of editing or modification is required in rest of the files. Okay, well, so this is the source code. One more thing, this entire repository is a public repository. You should be able to access it even if you don't have fork this repository, or even if you are not added as a contributor here, you should be able to access it by just using any web browser. Okay, I'll share the link with you so that you can access it easily. Now, let me just check if my resources are created. Yes, I can see my resources are there. If I do az-aks list, it should show me one Kubernetes cluster over there. You will notice one Kubernetes cluster is already there, my AKS-01. It's already ready. Only thing I'm going to do is I'm going to get the admin credentials now. Done. Let's check that once again. Yes, I got the right credential now set. What I will do now, let us try to check how many nodes I do have in my cluster. And you will notice there are three nodes by default created. I'll also check if there are any pods. There are no pods. There are no deployments. You will notice there is nothing other than this default Kubernetes service API. This is Kubernetes REST API server, by the way. Okay, so we are ready now. Let's also try the ACR. Just want to see if ACR is also created, az-acr list, and you will notice that my ACR is already ready. Guess what? We can now jumpstart our project. So what I'll do, I'll visit my dev.azure.com account. This is how you log in into your dev.azure.com account. If you already have an account, you just have to, you know, log in with your email ID and password. But if you do not have an account created, you can sign up for creating a new account as well. Let's go ahead and create a new project. Here I'm going to say my project name is AKS-Temo01. I want this project to be a public project. Create. That's my new project that I'm creating now. Okay, now I'll straight away go to the core section, and you will see there is an empty Git repository created. What we can say, a bare repository with no commits, nothing. Let's go ahead with an import option here. This will allow me to import my this GitHub repository directly in here. So let's go here and just copy this URL. Please remember, this is a public repository. You are free to clone it into your Azure DevOps subscription as well. It won't actually require any kind of authentication at all. And you can make changes to this, your copy of source code, without affecting my original repository. It's on the way. It's copying all the source code now. Once the source code is properly copied, yeah, it's done already. Let's navigate to the code view, and that's my project. But we are not interested in the master branch right now. We are actually going to build it for the AKS CD branch. So let's switch to AKS CD branch. Everything is ready already now. What I'll do next, my project is already cloned into this particular repository, is already cloned, you can say, into Azure repos. I'm going to create my pipeline now. Create a pipeline. Here we'll select use classic editor pipeline. You can also use YAML pipeline as well. But I feel classic pipeline is much easier to build. Oh, wait. I made a mistake in here. I just have to go back. Okay. Branch I'm going to build now is AKS CD branch. Okay. So let's continue. Type of project, you are free to choose whatever template matches your application architecture. Right now, I'm going to start with an empty job. This gives me much more flexibility. One more thing, you might be actually having some kind of difficulty with Azure pipelines. You will notice a message here. Pipelines in region may be impacted by live site incident. I was getting this type of error for more than 1 month now. So I found an alternative for that. Instead of using the Microsoft hosted build agent, I'm going to use self-hosted build agent. I have already created my own Azure pipeline agent as a Azure VM, and I'm going to just launch it now. This is my VM. So AZ VM start, name of my VM is this, and it's from resource group AZ400 Sonar. Okay, this should start the virtual machine. And once virtual machine is started, I'm going to connect to that virtual machine using my another WSL window. Let's just wait for the virtual machine to show the status as running. Now, for here, I'm going to choose my agent pool as default agent pool. Okay, the virtual machine that I'm launching right now is part of this default agent pool. I have already configured it. Let's now go to the Get Sources button. Here we are getting sources for AKS CD. And then in build agent job, the very first job I'm going to do now is not building the container images yet. I need to replace the tokens in Docker Compose file first, because I'm going to use that Docker Compose file as an input for my next step, which is Docker Compose step or run Docker command step. So let's add one step here. And the step which I'm going to use now is replace token. This is replace token. Right now I'm planning to replace tokens in Docker Compose file. Root directory, no need to provide any directory right now, because if you don't provide any directory name, the default directory name would be root of your source code. You just need the file name, however. So let me provide the file name. That's my file name. Okay. So we have docker-compose.yaml and okay. Now, we need to configure a few more parameters in here. So let's go to the advanced section, and you will see it's asking you for the token prefix and token suffix. I'm going to replace the value with double underscore here. So what does it mean? In the file docker-compose.yaml, it will be looking for a token which has double underscore before it and double underscore after it. and then it's going to replace with the existing variables. So let's define a variable here. Now, what two variables are required? If you have a look at this Docker Compose file, let's have a look at Docker Compose file. There are only two parameters that need to be replaced. Number one is API image, and number two is DB image. So that's what I'm going to introduce here. API image is the name, and here I'm going to just write my API image name should be inclusive of the container registry name, or you can just leave it for a time being. Let's call it API app colon dollar round bracket build dot build ID. Let me just check if this predefined variable name is right. Predefined variables. Let's go to the predefined variables and see if the build number is a correct predefined variable here. No, these are system variables. I do not want system variables. I want build.build number probably. Definition name. Yeah, build number should be written like this. Or you can use build ID. Okay, build ID, I guess it is right. Only thing is the D should be small instead of capital. So I'll just change this into build ID. You can also use build number instead of build ID. No issues. So this is my API app. This is going to be the image name, and this is going to be the version tag for the image. Same way, I'm going to provide a DB image parameter where I'm just going to say it's an API DB colon dollar round bracket build dot build ID. So the same build ID will be actually appearing here in both the images as their version tag. This is very important for us for building the correct image. Let us save it, but not queue it. Okay, I'm not planning to queue it immediately now because some of the additional steps need to be there now. Anyway, let's go back to the task. You will see replace token task is now completed. This task is supposed to, find and replace those placeholders into Docker Compose file and replace them with the proper values from my variables. What's going to do next? Next, I'm going to include the Docker step. So let's say build and push Docker images. I'm going to add this task. So we need to provide the container registry. Wait a second. I guess this is my custom one. I don't want this. I will use the one which is available from Docker, from the extension. Yeah, Docker Compose. This is what I need. So I will add run Docker Compose. Here it requires me to provide the container registry details and also the file name and all the other parameters. So let's do one thing. Let us first connect my Azure DevOps account to my Azure account. Now, which I have done here is both my Azure DevOps account and my Azure subscription are using same credentials. So I can simply select the Azure subscription here, click the authorize button, and authorize myself to have access to my subscription. Let me enter my email account. This is my Microsoft Azure login, Azure Cloud login. Here we provide the password, login, and this will authorize Azure DevOps to have access to my Azure subscription. This will provide co-administration or co-admin access, right? I'm just waiting for the authorization to be completed now. Yes, authorization completed. It will ask you for container registry name. You can just pick it up immediately here. My container registry name right now is my ACR101. Then it's asking me for the Docker Compose file location. So let me just choose the file from here. And if you need any kind of additional parameters, you can pass them here. But I guess it's not required. There is a special checkbox, qualify image name, which is very important one. What this one will do? if you notice our variables simply include the image tag, that is API app, API DB, and the version number. But it doesn't begin with the ACR part. That's what we are actually going to do. We are going to automatically make it configure to use, the container registry, qualified container registry name. Command which I want to run as of now is going to be a build step. Now, why build step? Because I just want to build the container images first. Later, I'm going to replicate this step, but instead of build, I'm going to use another command, push. So let's do one thing. Let's say the display name here is build both container images. Both container images means it is going to build both application and database container image. Let's clone this task. And here I'll say push both images. Everything else will be same. Only thing that's going to be different here is instead of build, I'm going to use push steps. So this will now push it to the container registry. So I hope you will understand the process here or the flow here. First, I'm going to replace the tokens in Docker Compose file using the variables that I have defined. That will let me set my image names or image tags. Then I'm going to use Docker Compose build and Docker Compose push to build and push the container images to my ACR registry respectively. Next, I'm going to simply replace the tokens once again, but not this time in Docker Compose file, but this time I'm going to update container registry name and all the other details in my next file, which is the Kubernetes configuration file. But before that, let us test this much of my steps. Wait a second, I guess my my agent VM is not yet ready. Let's connect to it first. Okay, here it is. Need to connect to this VM here. You can either connect using public IP or you can connect using the DNS. It's your choice, by the way. I hope I have entered the right password. Yeah, it's the right password. Fine. So this is the agent directory, and this is where I'm going to run this run.sh to launch an interactive Azure Pipeline agent. Yes, now this VM will start acting like Azure Pipeline agent. Okay, connected to my Azure DevOps account. And now it will be waiting for the jobs to run. So it's now listening for the job. Let's go back to this pipeline here, and you will notice my pipeline currently has these three steps, which I'm going to just test. Let's go to save and queue, run it here. And I want this to run on my default agent pool, which includes this particular build agent, which I have configured, pre-configured rather. Here it is, it's now in a queue. Okay, now it has started. You will see it's doing checkout step where it is basically just downloading all the source code. After that, it has done replace token step. You will notice that token has been replaced in two places in docker-compose.yaml. After that, it has done building the two container images, like one for DB and one for app. And now what it is trying to do is it's trying to push these images. Right? It is trying to push these images to my new container registry. Meanwhile, I'll just open my Azure portal here to show you how many container images are currently there in my container registry. So let's go to the container registry here. Here is my container registry. And you will notice in my container registry, if I go to repositories, I have got one image appearing there right now, which is API DB. The other one should also appear there in just a few minutes. Looks like my database image has been pushed and my application image is currently getting pushed over there. Let's check the tag. You will see the tag here appears as 541. That is my build ID, by the way. That's my build ID environment variable. Okay, so everything looks like it's working just fine. Yeah, both my images are now pushed. So I have done with task number one, setting up a CI pipeline to continuously build my application and push the container images to my ACR, Azure Container Registry. Okay. Now, moving on next, we need to still work on this build pipeline because I want my build pipeline to also produce the required Kubernetes deployment files or make necessary changes to Kubernetes deployment files. So let's edit it once again. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to create one additional variable where I need to provide my ACR name, Azure Container Registry name. What is my ACR name? You can get that from your Azure portal. Like for example, AZ ACR list. There's only one ACR, my ACR 101. So let me include that here. Dot Azure CR dot IO. Now please remember this is your login server URL. Okay, or ACR registry URL. You can get the URL from here. Okay. And let me update my application images to also include this URL as a prefix. I'm doing it not for Docker Compose, but I'm doing it for my Kubernetes artifact. Docker Compose doesn't need this prefix, right? Because the step that I have selected or the checkbox that I have selected in previous steps, Docker build step, that will ensure that this prefix is automatically added. But I want this not to be automatically added, but I want this to be added through this environment variable so that it will properly update my Kubernetes deployment artifacts as well. Fine. Let's go back to the task. You will notice that we no longer need this checkbox, qualify image name. It's no longer required because our image name already contains the login server URL. But please remember it is completely safe to keep this checkbox checked in because internally what Azure DevOps will do, it will check if your image name begins with an URL or begins with your login server URL. If yes, then there is no need to do further operations. But if no, only then it will add a prefix. So you can ignore this checkbox for a time being now. And let's add a new replace token step. Again, replace tokens. And this time, this replace token is for Kubernetes artifacts. Let's say KSS artifacts. Root directory this time would be KSS deployment directory. This is where all the artifacts are. And I'm expecting only two files where I need change. Okay, guess what? Only two files which requires some changes are deployment files. appdeploy.yaml and dbdeploy.yaml. So let's do one trick. Let's say my file name filter should be deploy.yml, asterisk hyphen deploy.yml. That will filter out only these two files, filter these two files, appdeploy and dbdeploy. And it will ignore rest of the files in this directory. That is what I expect to do. Then, just like last time, I will go to the advanced section and here I'm going to replace it with double underscore here. That's it. We are just trying to search for those two container image parameters there and we are planning to replace them. In Azure DevOps build pipeline, after you make changes to any file in your source repository, you will have to save those changes or you will have to immediately copy them from the source directory to artifact staging directory. And guess what? There is a step available there, which is called copy files. So let's use copy files. And in this copy files, what I'm going to do now, a very regular step rather, we are going to select the source folder. Okay. This is our source folder and we are going to search for all the contents into uh, build dot, wait a second, I guess I should use another template here. This was an earlier option that used to perform both the operations, copy and build artifact, but this is no longer recommended. What is recommended now is to use just the copy files parameter. Okay. Copy. KFS. Deployment. Artifacts. We need to provide the source folder location. We can use variables also. So let's see what variables we can use in here. I need source directory, all the contents, not all the contents actually, I want contents, or let's say I just want content from a particular folder, KTS deployment, all the files, not all, I want YAML files, and the target folder should be, artifact staging directory should be the next folder. This should be the staging directory. Make sure that you use round brackets and a dollar symbol to make sure that it is properly formatted as an environment variable. So this will copy Kubernetes artifact after the replace token command. What I want to do next is publish. Now this is interesting one because this is the step which will actually copy all the artifacts to the drop folder. Here it is, publish build artifacts. Here in publish build artifact, I'm going to just pick up whatever we have copied here in previous step in build dot artifact staging directory. We will create a artifact name drop and we will publish it to Azure pipeline storage. Now my build pipeline is finally finished and I'm going to save and queue it now. Let's save and queue on the same default agent and let's wait for the log. You can also check your default agent from here. Looks like it has completed the first job and it's now going to fire another job. Yeah, it started already. You will see job is now in a queue. I'm doing a checkout now. Replace token is done. Build container, push container will not take much time. Yes, done. Good. Now the artifacts are also copied into the final artifact staging directory and from there, they will go to the drop location, drop container. You will notice the final artifact message here, one artifact produce. Let's go to one artifact produce. Here it is. And you will see all our Kubernetes artifacts are now here in this drop directory. Can you see that? Okay, fine. That's a good thing that our continuous integration pipeline is finally over. We have just did the continuous pipeline part. If you want to just confirm, let's just go to one of these files, let's say appdeploy.yaml and try to open it with our default notepad. I just want to see what that this file actually contains. You will notice this file now contains my image name, which is a fully qualified image name, including the container registry name, forward slash, image tag and version number, everything is already there. So they are properly formatted and I'm finally going to be able to deploy it into my AKS. Do not worry, it won't take more than 10 minutes now. What I will do, I'll just try my kubectl get pod command to check if there are any pods in there. And also I will check if there are any deployments and if there are any services. Pod, deploy and service. I just want to see services written as SVC, not as SRV. So you will see there are no pods and deployment. There is only one default service. That's fine. That's going to change now. Let's create another type of pipeline called release pipeline in Azure DevOps, which is actually responsible for deploying your application or for setting up CD pipeline. Again, just like last time, I'm going to use empty job and this is going to be my dev slot. For a build artifact, I'm going to pick up my existing build pipeline. So it's going to use those YAML files produced by my build pipeline. Okay, here it is. And we will add this to a stage, dev stage. And in dev stage, you can choose which build agent you want. Like for example, you can choose to use Azure Pipeline agent, or you can choose the custom build agent that I have created. I will continue with the built-in build agent. Let's add a step. As usual, the first step is going to be, just kubectl. There are no more steps actually. Let's just run the kubectl step. And what we need here is, we just need to provide the service connection for Kubernetes. Wait a second, we are using AKS. No need for providing Kubernetes service connection. We can instead provide Azure service connection here. The one that we have created in build pipeline, same I can reuse in my release pipeline. This will automatically filter all the resource groups and give you only one resource group which contains Kubernetes cluster. Then select the cluster here. That's the only cluster right now I have. And I need admin credentials for accessing this cluster. Otherwise, you will get RBAC related errors. Command which I'm going to fire here is a very basic apply command. Use configuration files, and I'm going to provide here the configuration files from this folder. You will notice I'm just going to select the drop folder. I'm not going to provide any individual .yaml file. One very good thing about kubectl apply command is that instead of providing a file name, if you provide a directory name, it will take all the YAML files from that directory and apply them one by one. That is what I expect to do. That's the only thing to do basically. Fine. No need of any kind of variables this time. I do not need any variables here because the YAML file already contains all the required steps. Let's save this and create the release. Okay, this will create a new release. Let's go to release one. And you can even set this to auto deploy, which is actually, I guess, happening already. It's already doing auto deploy now. We are just waiting for the build agent to be ready. This time I have selected Microsoft hosted build agent. I can see now build agent has been picked up and it's downloading the artifacts, and yeah, it's now doing kubectl apply. Let's wait. Yeah, looks like it's doing all the apply part already. Let's go back to our Kubernetes cluster and run the previous command. I just want to see all pods, deployment and SVCs. And this time you will notice